Hello and welcome to yet another episode of Striking Chords. In our series to showcase talents on our very own campus, we have a very unique artist and a very unique style of play for music. And his name is Kevin. A very warm welcome to our show, Kevin.
Thank you for calling me to your studio.
So, Kevin, music runs in your family. What was your first encounter with music?
I would say that was when I was around 6 years old. That was my earliest memory of at least my performance, at least in singing. But I've been introduced to music since I was very little, because my family is very they love music. They're all very passionate about music. Yeah.
So, music runs in your family. Mm-hmm. Can you tell us, like, what kind of music do you play in your family? Like, if you have dinner or lunch together, you play music. Is that the kind of family that you're talking about?
No. It's not nothing like that. But, of course, my dad, my eldest brother, me, and my little brother, we play the guitar, of course. And but my mom and my two elder sisters, they do not play the guitar, but one of my elder sisters plays the same keyboard.
Do you still recall it? When was the first time you picked up a guitar or any musical instrument that you played?
I was given formal training by my eldest brother, my first formal training, because he was a professional musician by then, when I was in my standard six, and he learned his music skills, guitar skills, Western classical guitar skills from his pre-university days, which was in his 11th and 12th class. And other than that, my parents have sort of driven this music sense into me, because I was encouraged to sing from when I was very young. And they also sing almost all the time, as in every even when they're working, they'll be humming some tunes and songs and stuff like that. So that music is incorporated into every aspect of our lives. So it started from that and has sort of branched out into me playing classical music again.
Since you started at a very tender age of six, so at school, were you the guy where people running after you with guitar in your hand, where people look up or people want to be like you in school?
No, not really. I was a very small kid, and plus holding a guitar, the guitar looks much bigger than me. And but other than that, I wasn't very outgoing. I didn't socialize. I do socialize, but mostly with my relatives and a few of my friends. I continued practicing, but there were no girls running after me, of course.
Nobody is interested in you at that. So, when was the first time you played on a stage, like in front of people? Do you still remember the feeling that you had?
Right. My first official performance was when I was in my 10th grade, just before my matric exam. Some of the students gathered together from our school and performed a concert. And in it, I performed a few classical pieces. And that was my my first concert experience. Yeah, and it was a lot of fun.
You specialize in Western classical music.
Right.
And in contemporary world, not many people play Western classical music. Mm-hmm. So can you tell us more about what is Western classical music?
When you talk about Western classical music, the first difference that you'll see in terms of style is that the Western classical musicians use their four fingers of their right hand, except for the little finger, from the thumb to the ring finger. And so they use this to cover all of the strings. We usually play six strings in the guitar, right? And so we play six strings with his four fingers. But for electrical guitarists, lead guitarists and those who play other forms of guitar, they mostly use the pick, something called either a pick or a plectrum. Right, either could be a metallic one or it could be plastic mostly, one. Most of the time it's a plastic one. And so you use it in order to strum the strings of the guitar or to pluck the strings of the guitar. If you talk about bass guitar players, they use mostly these two fingers, either the plectrum or these two fingers, because they just have four strings to cover. And relatively, if you're proficient in Western classical music, then the number of notes that is produced is more. As in, you can say, in easy terms, you can say the surround sound is, there's more surround ambient sound when you play classical music.
Western classical music, how is it really different from the Indian classical music? Can tell us more about that?
Yeah, Indian classical music and Western classical music differ in the way they use the seven basic notes. For example, you have the, in Western terms, do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. That's from do to do. That's called an octave. That's the eighth note, which repeats the same note or the same sound, but at a different pitch. In Western classical music, these notes are sort of vocalized spot on. And there's not much of, something called slurs. But a slur is a combination or is a connection of two notes, two types of notes, in a single breath. For example, that's a slur between two different notes, if you vocalize two distinctive notes, that's without a slur. And so Western music mostly goes spot on with the notes and the beats, with this different notes. But Indian classical, they tend to vary a lot, put a lot of slurs between notes. And so it's quite interesting and to see the difference between these two types
Indian
of
and Western
classical and yeah, music.
I can see you're very passionate about music and you have vast knowledge about music, especially the style of music that you play. Who have been your inspiration? Who has been instrumental in leading you the way in playing music?
It was and is my dad, first and foremost, of course, because he's been a very music-oriented person. His passion has been always for music, although his actual profession was, until recently, a medical doctor. He retired recently, and he is pursuing his passion by forming a church choir in our church back at home. And he continues to lead that that choir. And wherever he goes, he tries to gather some people and to brush up their skills so that their vocal skills would be at an acceptable level, so that whenever they're needed, they can go over and perform. And my eldest brother is also a huge musical influence and inspiration for me. He is a professional musician, and he has progressed from Western classical to studying something called indigenous music, where each tribe has different groups of people have different types of music. Yeah. And so my eldest brother is studying, going more depth into these kinds of music. When he taught me, when I was in class 6, he taught me gave me the foundations of Western classical music. And so I draw my inspiration from that. I draw my ideas from that also. So whatever I play is a variation of those ideas that he has taught me. And of late, I have been this thing quite interested in types of people like Antoine Dufour, with very proficient in the guitar, and they use different types of guitars. They use a fusion of a guitar as well as you know the harp, right?
Yeah.
You know the harp? Yeah. With those lots of strings. So they use a combination of these things, and so contemporary guitar playing is very interesting, a lot of fun. But it has its roots from Western classical again. And also my most recent interest in terms of style of music has been from by a person called Kaki King. And this person is a she, not a guy. And she has composed music for the very popular Hollywood film called August Rush. Composed some of the if not most of the scores, some of the scores, and especially the you can say the climax of the movie where the lead actor, the little boy, was playing guitar with the guitar on the floor, and then that's called slapping the guitar. So he's slapping around, producing many different notes, new tunes. It was very good, and so it's contemporary this in guitar playing. It's very a lot of fun. It's a little difficult because it incorporates a lot of other styles of guitar playing also, but it is influencing me as of late, as of now.
Other than music, what are the other activities that you indulge in your spare time?
I like reading books, watching movies. Books, when I say books, I mean books and movies. I mean fiction, mostly fiction. Okay. Action, fiction, comedy, and science fiction, of course. Also, I like goofing around a lot. Okay. And doing a lot of physical activity, either exercising or going on treks or just hanging out with friends.
Thank you so much. It's time we go for a very short break. We'll be right back after this very short commercial break. Stay tuned. Welcome back to Striking Chords. We are in conversation with a very unique artist, Kevin Rizyang Panmay. Kevin, I'd like to know more. Are you a full-time musician now, or do you have other activity?
No, I'm not a full-time musician because I'm pursuing my master's second year in communication in the University of Hyderabad. And this is my life right now. And music is an aside to this other, to my academic activities. So first and foremost, I'm a student, so I'm trying to focus my energies on that. But music was, is, and will continue to be a part of my life, a big part of my life.
So considering your academic ambition and your future ambition, you want to shift from music to work, to become a media person.
No, I'd like to be both because
okay.
I think, for example, if you're making a film, then you need musical
Okay.
source, of course. So even if I'm, for example, if I'm the producer of a movie, and I can, if I have the time, then I can make my own music. If I'm very proficient and listening, if I am, if I would like to do it, then I can do it. So that'll also cut costs also.
Okay.
I mean, let's talk economy,
okay.
right?
So you play guitar. Other than guitar, is there any musical instruments that you play or that you like playing?
I used to play the keyboard when I was much younger. As an I took some lessons, but over the course of time, I've been out of practice, so very rusty with it.
Okay.
And I know a little basics about the violin, but you wouldn't be able to stay in the same room with me when I start playing.
So, coming from a very small town in Manipur, very small village in Manipur, all the way to Hyderabad, a big city, how has the journey been like? And what is the difference in a musical scenario back in your home place and back in Hyderabad, if you have to compare?
First and foremost, the topographical distance is huge.
Yeah.
There are a lot of opportunities over here, and for example, if you want to start your own enterprise, then startups, it's quite difficult to get capital over there.
Oh.
Over here, there are quite a good number of venture capitalists and people who are willing to fund for startups also. Apart from that, you have other job opportunities of joining multinational corporations or other well-known brands,
yeah.
even. And so such opportunities present itself. So it's the opportunities is wide ranging. And for there are lots of opportunities and rooms for people with diverse skills. So this big cities like Hyderabad, they provide a lot of good opportunities for that. So that's also one of the reasons why I came. And in terms of music, at least Western musical influence is still in its nascent stage here in Hyderabad as of now. And in my place, it has sort of matured to a degree. But of course, the indigenous music influence is very mature over here. And of course, you have the cinema music, which
yeah.
is always very vibrant, yeah. But other than that, it's a big city, and it's growing at a very fast pace, and also music, Western music, is also catching on quite fast. And especially the rock music culture, it's a very fast-growing music influence, yeah. And you have such stereotypes, for example, that people from the Northeast
can play any
instrument and sing.
Yeah, yeah.
You pick anyone who you see, and then they'll be able to sing and play the guitar. Yeah.
Yeah.
But there are small elements of truth in that, in the sense that the music culture over there is quite vibrant.
Yeah.
Western music influence is quite vibrant, as opposed to here in Hyderabad.
Okay. And on the last note, as you've seen in the campus, you've been here for the last 1 year,
mm-hmm.
the music fraternity is growing day by day.
Right.
And so, being a musician yourself, is there anything you want to say to the music-loving people here in the campus?
I would say that it's always good to update your, let's say, music sense, because there are new types of music being produced every, let's say, music season, because you have Christmas time, you have Christmas music,
Christmas, yeah.
and then January, and then the same. You have winter, I mean, autumn again, spring. So these, the seasons also define the types of music that which is being produced a lot. So for each season, I think it's good to explore new artists. And so by exploring new artists, you can gain, let's say, knowledge about new different types of growing music experiences or influences, types of music being created. And there are a lot of other upcoming artists who are relatively unknown, who are making great, very great music. There are a lot of good, well-established music artists, of course, but it has sort of become saturated over the years. And so I think it's good to explore fresh talent, and you can do these by going to websites such as Jamendo.com, where they give Creative Commons license for most of the music that is put over there, so that everyone can listen and download, because they're promoting new talent, new music culture over there. And I think it's good to, since we have the internet at our disposal, go and explore such websites, such avenues, so that you can have a better understanding of what type of music you like. If you know, for example, if you experience what you don't like, then you know what you like, right? So that's also one way of looking at it,
Okay, thank you so much for coming on our show and sharing your info with us.
Thank you.
It was such a pleasure talking to you. That's all the time that we have in Striking Chords. We look forward for more appearance by such star, such musician like Kevin. But stay tuned for exclusive performance by Kevin after this very short break.
Introducing the next revolution in beauty. Get ready to experience a whole new you.
It's you, perfected.
Say goodbye to fine lines and wrinkles and hello to full lips, sparkling eyes, and lashes that never end. And that's just the beginning. Transform your look the way celebrities do with this beauty industry secret that's now available for the first time ever. Introducing Photoshop by Adobe. Finally, look the way you've always dreamed. The difference is clear. Just one application of Photoshop can give you results so dramatic, they're almost unrealistic. Use Healing Brush to target blemishes at their source by simply erasing them. Pro Pixel Intensifying Photanical Hydrojargon Microbead Extract infused with nutritive volumizing technology will leave your face virtually unrecognizable.
My skin feels like plastic!
Take control of your color with Hue Saturation. Use this breakthrough formula to change hair or skin color, brighten eyes, whiten teeth, even adjust your race. Tired of fighting with your shape? Wish you could be a total knockout? Dial in the perfect you with Liquify. Reshape your body without the expense and mess of surgery. Why eat healthy and exercise when you can just look like you do? And the best part is?
It won't rub off.
The results don't lie. Pictures like this are all Photoshop. The celebrity beauty secret used in virtually every major magazine is now available to you. You don't have to rely on a healthy body image or self-respect anymore.
Now that's the power of Photoshop.
There's only one way to look like a real cover girl. Photoshop by Adobe.
Maybe she's born with it.
No, I'm pretty sure it's Photoshop.